And welcome back to the Resto Coach. Anthony Sta here together with Resto Coach Rommel. Now, before anything else, of course, ipas na natin pag medyo nagugutom na ako, partner. Thank you. Mga binibigyan na sa ating mga pagkain dito. Makakain na tayo in a while. Thank you, of course, the signature wings. And the glove. Right. Perfect.
Thank you, Chi.
Thank you. Okay, now we're going to be talking about, well, we've got gloves here as well. And we're going to be talking about, for our episode, obviously, is the experience. So, obviously, ano ang kailangang experience na gusto mo iparating sa mga customers na papasok?
Well, gusto nating iugnay muna dun sa last topic natin, last episode. Signature dish, andito na, no? And then, yung mga complimentary dishes, na kumpleto mo na yung menu. And then, ang tanong, how do you want to serve it? Ano yung feel? Ano yung energy? Ano yung vibe? Nakita mo yung uniform nga. Kasama pa din yun. No? American casual dining restaurant, wing joint, so yung uniform is American.
Yes.
No? Naka-shorts, hindi ganong formal. No? All of those come into play. And then when you talk about the experience, it's the type of hospitality. No? Kanina, nakangiti. Nakita niya, busy tayo, so hindi ganang nagsasalita. So, kino-customize. Yun yung mga ganong fine details na tinuturo sa mga tao.
So that's step number two, because if you haven't joined us last week, what we talked about is the fact of coming up with a signature dish. Ito na nga yung signature dish, meron po silang wings. And now, you're talking about the overall experience because you want it to be complete. Pagpunta ng tao, hindi sila nag-enjoy sa pagkain, pero nag-enjoy din sila sa pagpunta mo talaga yes. Sa isang lugar.
Siguro yung isa sa mga importanteng tips is when you start, ano ba yung gusto mong gawing klase ng restaurant? Marami yan eh, it's a spectrum of things. Like, do you want to just open a kiosk, a cart? No, a fast QSR, fast food, or do you want to do a fast casual, parang mas polished na QSR, or do you want to do a casual dining? In our case, it's casual dining. Ibig sabihin, you just sit, the customers just sit on the table and they get served. So, napaka-importante yan, and a lot of the business success, doon mo madedetermine because it also affects the size of the store, no, the labor cost, obviously. So, yun yung mga fine details na kailangan may consider. What type of service do I want to provide? Before yung hospitality pa,
right.
What type of service? Is it fast food service, QSR, or quick service restaurant?
Right.
And then, fast casual ba siya? Casual dining, so on.
Nung pumasok ka dito, you and your partners thought of coming up with what? What was your vision?
Casual dining. Kasi ang talagang buo kami doon because we wanted to offer American casual dining experience at a reasonable price.
Okay.
Kasi yung frustration din sa mga dati namin pinagtrabawan, no? Nakikita namin yung guest, well, talaga, medyo matataas lang ang level, no? Yung antas. Meron mga pangaraniwang tao, pero sa mga special locations, ha? So we wanted to bring it to the masses, so to speak, no? Sa mainstream. Ma-experience nyo yung authentic American casual dining food, pero mas reasonably priced. Okay. Kaya mo siyang kainin on a weekday, kaya mo siyang kainin on a weekend.
Tama. Now for the listeners and the viewers out there, what should they ask themselves? Bago sila magtayo, kasi ikaw, inihambing mo yun sa experience nyo ng mga partners. That's why you came up with the casual dining. Now, for all of those listening to us right now, what should they be thinking of if they want to be able to come up with their own experience?
Actually, automatic yun, bro. Kung ano yung pagkain mo, dapat tumutugba yung servisyo na yun. Kasi like, for example, imagine serving etong mga gantong items sa naka-necktie, naka long sleeves, no, hindi siya babagay. So, sabi ko nga kanina, doon mo marirealize ngayon, no, yung pinagkikwentuhan natin, the menu itself, the signature dish will determine the signature experience that you want to communicate and you want to provide.
So, everything starts with that.
So, madali lang siya. Madali lang siya.
For example, nagdala ka ng gloves. What are you asking now the customers to experience when you bring in the gloves instead of actually using the utensils?
Well, in all humility, we started with utensils because hindi naman kami nag-invento ng gloves. People started asking for gloves because they wanted to eat it with hands. Ang una namin mga posters, ayan, hanggang ngayon, nandiyan pa siya, best enjoyed buffalo style. Bawal lang spoon and fork. Pero totoo nun, wala kasi kami dishwashing machine nung araw. So we just wanted to.
Yes.
But it evolved into an experience. And right. We realized, pag nag-gloves yung tao, when you wear the gloves, no, for example, ito nga, pinot mo yung gloves mo.
Yes, correct.
No? And then you grab the wings. Hindi na kailangan maghugas ng kamay, malinis, masanitary, or hindi na napapasa. And then hindi rin sila, ito, secondary na to, natukasan namin. They cannot do their phones anymore. So, mas nagiging social experience din, no? So, yun yung inoobserbahan lang namin na behavior ng tao. And you'll be surprised, some people, when they get the wings, they put the rice on the basket and they eat it by hand.
Eh, yun naman ang ginagawa natin yes, kasi.
Pinoy. Kamay naman ito. So, yun yung experiential aspect na natutunan ng customers doon sa product na sinerve mo. Kaya sabi ko nga sa'yo, napakahalaga nung last episode, develop your menu with the experience, not only the food, but the experience in mind.
You know, maybe you can actually do that. I like that idea of people having to leave their phones at the door before you come in. Because that does add to the experience. Because yes. Yung mga tao ngayon, unfortunately, hindi na nag-uusap eh.
Well, sabi nga, no, as I've mentioned before, there are two reasons why people would choose your restaurant. The logical reason and then the emotional reason for it. And yun yung, kung gusto mong maging sustainable, mag-grow yung restaurant mo, masishield siya from being replaced by online, no? Kailangan mas experiential siya. And it becomes more experiential when you introduce yung mga gantong items like gloves, no, the casual dining service of it. Kasi pag pumipila yung tao, medyo mas less experiential din siya.
But at the same time, obviously, you talked about the fact that yes, maganda nga yung meron kang set procedure, so to speak. But at the same time, you can also grow. Pag nakikita mo naman yung mga customers at nakikita mo rin kung ano yung mga hilig nila, kung ano yung mga hinahanap nila, pwede mo naman itagtag yun. Eventually.
Yes, we adjust. That's why, you know, simula kami, wings lang. And then, now we have burgers also, sliders. But yun, yung format namin is not the big burgers, but the sliders because it's about sharing. Yun din yung isang tip, no? A lot of yung Pilipino, mahilig yan sa mga sharing concepts. Kaya ang daming Chinese restaurants dito sa Pilipinas eh. Because, you know, try eating in a Chinese restaurant na mag-isa ka. Malang bill mo. Pero pag 12 kayo, 10, o kaya 6, or 4 lang, mas mura because patak-patak. And you know, experience. When you share food, like yung triple supper, you get 3 sauces, and you can get to try 3 sauces.
3 different.
Kasi 2 kayo, 3 kayo, and then you get, you know, variety. Mahilig ang Pilipino rin sa variety. So all of these things come into play when you talk about being experiential.
And so, you can also, remember, you always have to continue to be able to evolve. Pero maganda kasi sinasabi mo, you come up with a signature dish, you come up with the experience that you want people to be able to have. But then at the same time, kumagalaw ka rin eventually pag nakikita mo yung kumapasok sa'yo.
Yes, yung sabi ko sa'yo kanina, di ba, the hospitality side of it. Dati, menu presentation. Ngayon, menu conversation. Dati, making a lot of statements about the food, you're expected to know the description of the food by, kami ganun, noong 90s eh. But ngayon, it's more of a menu conversation. You just ask customers questions. Did you like to have wings today or chicken fingers? What sauce would you like to have? It's more participative and interactive. Para makakompete ka rito. Kasi ang tao, 90% of the time, nandito.
That's right. So you think that's where we're moving towards? That the experience of actually moving away or veering away from the regular menu. Tapos yun ang pinupuntahan lang
yes,
talaga.
Marami. No? The QSRs now, they have digital boards. You can actually not interact with three people and still order. And we'll touch on that more as we continue.
Eh, may naalala lang ako isang kwento. Ikikwento ko yun sa aming pagbabalik dito, still talking about experience.